Hey, everybody!
I have a very important announcement to make. This stunning woman by my side is Gail. She is your new arts and crafts counselor. But more to the point, she's my wife-to-be. Gail and I met at a singles disco mixer at the Portsmouth Marriott. And when I saw this little lady's electric slide, well, I was a goner. Do it, honey.
I just want to say that I'm so pumped to be part of the Camp Firewood family this year. I finally get to put my arts degree from RISI to good use. And most of all, I'm really excited to become Mrs. Jonas Jurgensen. In fact, we're getting married right here at camp today.
Hey, Gail, I hope you can cook because your husband's food tastes like if a skunk crawled into another skunk's ass and took a shit in it, and then both skunks died.
Joke! All right, everybody, back to lunch.
I suspected. Toxic waste.
Oh my god.
Given the consistency of the sludge, I'd say it's been seeping into the water table for weeks.
Jesus.
Given its proximity to the lakefront, I'd say we've got less than 24 hours to restore the ecology, or every living thing within 5 miles of here could die.
All right, we've got to go back to camp. Find Mitch, tell him what we saw in the woods, and get his take on the situation.
Let's go.
What is this?
It's your butthole!
Oh my god, Victor!
I'm an ultra-hiker!
Victor, do you think he knew it was you, Victor? Victor, do you think he knew it was you, Victor?
No, that guy's a dumb fuck.
What? You go fuck soup. Soup.
How about I cook you like a soup? I'll simmer you
and filter you through cheesecloth for stock. And then I'll add fresh vegetables and grains. And once I'm done, I want to kill you.
He says he's gonna kill me like a soup. Should I hang up? I'm not sure what to do. Should I say thank you? Thank you.
We got it! Mitch!
Save the camp!
Save the camp! How? Mitch!
Follow the money!
But how do we follow the money?
Get the code!
No! What code? What code?
No! Mitchell!
Smoked you out like salmon.
Oh.
have a problem.
The problem's with Mitch.
Long story short, he said he made a deal with Zenstar. We need you to hack into the government's mainframe computer and find proof of it.
Mainframe? Hack? Proof? It? Why do you come to me for help? I'm just a camp chef. I don't know a mainframe from a picture frame.
You see, Beth, I told you he's an idiot. He doesn't know his ass from a doorknob.
Jonas, Mitch told me something in confidence once. I know you were in the military. The NAM.
No way.
I'm quite sure I don't know what you're talking about.
I think you do know.
The fuck, dude?
We need your help, Jonas. We need the secret passcode to access the government computer.
Who's there?
Where's Mitch?
He's not here.
I want to talk to Mitch!
Mitch is dead!
What? Mitch is dead? I saw him like an hour ago.
Well, he died more recently than that. Fell into a pool of toxic waste in the woods, and now he's dead.
No, I'm not. I'm right here.
Mitch?
Down here. This is me.
Gary, Jonas has lost his mind. He's trying to kill me. You gotta hide me. You gotta hide me. I don't wanna die.
I don't wanna die.
Shh.
Jonas.
Victor!
Hey, Gary.
Victor! I know you're in here!
He's not here, Jonas.
Yes. Yeah. No. I gotta kill your friend, Victor. Just as soon as I find out where he's hiding.
Okay, look, I know that he prank called you.
But what about Gail? Aren't you supposed to be marrying her right now?
Oh, my God. Gail! Gail!
You can come out now.
Did you...
What's he doing? Sometimes, to access buried memories, you have to go back to the beginning of your life. Start from scratch.
Oh, Mummy, what a pretty, pretty kitty. But I don't want to go to the workhouse. Coach, I know it's only Pee-wee, and I got these spindly legs, but I'd sure like to get into a game.
Jenny, you want to go to the prom with me? Hey, man, want a dime bag?
Good smile, Jonas.
So I've disappointed your father. That's why I'm enlisting in the Merchant Marines.
Sir! Reporting for duty, sir! Charlie Bravo incoming, incoming! Lovable! Sir! I will defend the network access code! Sir! The code is 5798 Delta Alpha and Alpha November Tango Echo Niner 17562 Sierra Alpha Papa H India Alpha 437.
Got it!
Hell of a job, Jonas.
Jonas. Are you okay?
Yes. Thank you. Jonas, that's me, Jonas Jurgensen. I'm a camp chef and in love with Gail.
If anyone here so ever objects, let him speak now or forever hold his peace.
Wait. I object.
Oh, Jeff, the City Hall records clerk.
I know I hardly know you, Gail, but, in the short time we've spent together, I can honestly say that I've fallen madly, passionately in love with you. So what do you say? Give it a shot.
I'm sorry, Jean. I feel like if I don't at least explore this thing with Jeff, I might never be at peace. You understand, right?
That's what you want. what you both want, then that's what you should do.
Thank you, Gene.
Thanks, buddy.
Let's do it. Let's get married. Yeah!
By the power vested in me, I now declare you and you husband and wife.
What can I do for you? Parking ticket, fender bender, slip and fall. I'm undefeated with slip and fall cases. Public urination, too. Undefeated. Down at the courthouse, they call me Johnny Pisspot.
Oh, no, sir. This is much bigger.
We're in danger, sir. We need your help. We want to take on the U.S. government.
The U.S. government, you say? Hold on, my calls.
My client considers this a nuisance lawsuit, so to make you go away, we are prepared to offer you a settlement fee in the amount of $5 million, no more, no less.
You mean if we wanted less than $5 million, you'd say no?
That's what I said. It's a lot of moolah, Jimbo. Buy yourself a lot of shaving cream, shave that little mustache off your face.
No deal. This isn't about the money, Martinson. This is about giving a group of young people in Waterville, Maine, a summer filled with laughter and fun without dying from radioactive poison in the ground. Or maybe you've forgotten what it's like to be young, though. Oh, shit.
I enjoyed the speech, Jim. And if you're ever on a lecture circuit, I'll be sure to get some tickets for me and my friends. But as for tonight, I'm getting kind of hungry. We have a deal or not?
No. We do not. We'll see you later tonight in court.
Jim Stansel, are you insane?
Quite the opposite. I've just got nothing to lose. That doesn't make me insane. It makes me dangerous.
Dangerous is not the opposite of insane.
Oh, really? Well, what's the opposite of insane then, Professor?
Sane.
No.
The opposite of insane is insane.
I think he's right.
You want to get off me?
Jesus, Gene. What happened to you?
Life. Thanks, baby.
What do you want, Mitch? Can't you see I'm busy? You gotta come back to camp.
I left camp behind years ago. When I was fired.
What did you expect would happen, Gene? You went rogue. The menu would say grilled cheese and you'd make a taco. Or the menu would say hamburgers and you'd make a taco. Or the menu would say chicken soup and you'd make
tacos! I know what I did! And don't give me your holier than thou crap. Beth cared about you. Even after you became a candidate.
And how did you repay her?
You sucked and fucked your way through every waitress in New England.
You have no idea what my life has been like.
Oh, stop
After it! After the incident, I spent years in physical therapy, just learning how to walk. I still can't type. Don't you dare judge me.
And don't you dare judge me!
Jane, I didn't come here to fight you.
Well, then I guess you came to the wrong Winnebago.
Get a goddamn hold of yourself, Jane!
I don't want you here, bitch! Whatever it is you came for, I have nothing for you.
You may hate my guts, but I know that you love Camp Firewood. Now, are you going to be part of the problem, or are you the solution?
I'm in.
Thank God.
But if we do this, we're going to need some help.
I know just the guys.
Judge! Wait! I've got these to show.
What is this mockery? Objection, Your Honor.
Overruled, I'll allow it.
These are the discs that contain all the evidence against Zenstar.
Evidence, you say? I'll allow that. Let me... In light of the new evidence just presented, the court finds Zenstar guilty on all counts. And I'm hereby clean all of the toxic sludge out of the woods next to Camp Firewood.
Let the client know we're going to Plan B, call Falcon, and mobilize the troops. He'd best have no idea who they're dealing with.
Excuse me, what is that metal thing in your hand?
Nothing, never mind.
Really is a beautiful house.
Thank you.
Stucco.
Oh, you know me. I said to that realtor, I don't care how big or small the house is, it's just gotta have stucco.
I know how you feel about stucco.
I like brick face too, don't get me wrong, but...
It's no stucco!
Exactly. It certainly is not. So... If I know you, Gene, and I know you well, I know you didn't just come here to talk about stucco. What is it? What's weighing you down?
It's firewood, Gail. The camp's in danger.
Again?
Yeah, again. They need me. That means I need you. Gail, you know the ins and outs of that camp like you know the ins and outs of the back of your hand.
I can't, Gene. I've made a life for myself here. I have friends and responsibilities.
Damn it, Gail. We need you.
I have someone here who needs me. Jenny? Sweetie Pie, can you come down here for a second? Come here. Gene, I would like you to meet my daughter, Jenny. Jenny, this is Gene.
Hey.
Hey. Cool bandana. Right, back at you.
Jenny loves arts and crafts, just like her mother.
Oh, is that so?
She also loves to cook, just like her father.
Nice to meet you.
She likes to cook just like her father. That's so cool. I love to cook too.
Right. I'm talking about Eugene.
Eugene? Who's Eugene? Gotta go.
I'm sorry, Gene, but my life is here.
Tell Eugene's daughter I said goodbye. Gene seems like a good kid.
Let us pass, Nancy.
Nancy!
You way out of your league here. I don't want to hit a nurse.
Nancy, we don't have to do this.
Oh, yes, we do.
Sorry. You get to the missile. I'll try to hold her off.
It's suicide.
It's an
You gave it your best, but now it's time to say goodnight.
Let him go, Nancy.
Gail, you came back.
Oh, look, it's the arts and crafts counselor. Still looking for a husband?
Right now, I'm only looking for two things. A class on how to make your own papier-mâché pencil holder and an ass to kick. And it looks like I missed the class on how to make your own papier-mâché pencil holder.
That means you're gonna kick her ass.
Too bad you won't be around to see it.
The case today wasn't about big versus little or right versus wrong. It was about believing in yourself. And I wasn't alone up there. I couldn't have done this without the help of...
Without the help of who, Mr. Stancil?
Well, let's just say... three friends I'll never forget.
Are you talking about your brain, your heart, and your courage, sir?
A little presumptive leap, but yes, and you can put that on the record.
What's next for the hottest lawyer of the year?
Oh, stop, please. You're making me blush. I'm moderately attractive at best.
Our work here is done. We've got to get back to Cam.
I can't wait to tell Mitch and Jean the good news. Look at Jim. I'm so proud of him.
Mr. Stancil, I have time for one last question.
Compute death.
So cold.
I'm right here.
But you save the camp.
Now save the camp.
Guys might have fallen for the old ricochet move. Not me.
Jean!
Back!
Jean!
Are you okay? Are you okay? How could you let them take Mitch?
There's more to this story. A lot more. I executed procedure 865 Delta. Code name, the old switcheroo. Mitch is safe. I'm alive.
Whoa. Mitch, I thought I'd lost you forever.
I'm right here, baby.
Oh, Gene, God bless you, but how did you pull this off?
I had a man on the inside.
Hello, old friend.
Little Falcon?
Him? That man tried to kill me.
No, Falcon did exactly as he was ordered to do, but no military rank can trump brothers in arms.
That was one hell of a switch, brother.
Just like the old ones.
I was on your side the whole time.
Hold on.
If you were on my side, why would you try and kill me after the hypnotist show?
Oh, that, yeah.
And why did you have to kill Greg and Jim Stansel?
I'll admit, that part is pretty weird.
It feels more than weird. You killed two totally innocent people.
Well, if you think about it, I think it makes sense, I promise.
I don't want to beat a dead horse here. I just don't understand what's going on.
I'm sorry, but I have got to hit the road.
Yeah, that thing.
Yeah.
I just would like some clarity.
Okay. I'm hearing you. Uh-huh. And what I'm hearing is that this is bothering you, that many lives were lost. Now, I don't have an answer that I feel is going to satisfy you
at this moment.
But here's my thing. I just have to go. And if I don't go now, I'm either gonna have to cancel, which I could.
Not again.
If we could just beat by beat.
I completely agree. There are a lot of elements to this that do not make sense.
Look, I'm not trying to belabor a point here. I'm sorry if I made
you
angry.
I'm missing this thing, and I'm not mad at you. I'm just frustrated as well.
Mad at the situation. Well. So am I.
Look, guys, I'm glad. I think we got to a starting place, and I think that's good enough. Let him go. Now I'm gonna squirt some cherry juice on my pubic mound.
Wait, what did you just say pubic mound?
No, I said Puget Sound. I'm gonna take the train caboose to the Puget Sound. Leave me alone.